Welcome back to the channel, everybody. And if you're new here, hello, thanks for watching. If you like what you see, please like, comment, subscribe, do all that good stuff. This is Motor Mike Media, and as always, I'm Motor Mike, and today, well, we're talking about the 2021 Ford Bronco. The big Bronco is finally here, guys. It's in production, it's hitting dealerships now, and the big thing is journalists are getting their hands on it. They're driving it on-road and off-road and saying it's worth the wait. The hype is real, guys. A lot of journalists from so many different groups are all giving it such positive praise. It's always a good thing to hear. Now, we've waited a long time, but this is a direct competition versus the Jeep Wrangler. Same thing. They both have two-door and four-door configurations. Now, this is not a comparison video. I will make one of those in the future. We're just focusing on the Bronco today, but it looks like Jeep Wrangler finally has competition. The competition brings out the best in everyone. When they debuted the Bronco, well, Jeep decided, hey, guys, here's a big old VA engine in our Wrangler. See? Competition does work. Now, the Bronco and styling, the front end, it's squared off. Nice circle headlights, a big, bold presence to it. This is a modern interpretation of the first generation Bronco. It's awesome to see it here in real life. Now, the side profile, nice and boxy, very rugged looking, simple lines. I like the fenders. It's cool off-road touch. It's very different compared to what Jeep does. Now, like I said, it's not a Jeep comparison, but I like how it has similar traits to it, but has its own uniqueness. And the rear end, the big old tire in the back, good looking taillights. Now, this vehicle, just like the Wrangler, two-door and four-door, like I said, the doors come off, the roof comes off, all that good off-road goods. Now, let's talk about real quickly. We'll break down the actual numbers on this. Now, the Bronco itself, two-door configuration, I'll put some stats out for you guys, approach and all that good stuff. Now, with the Sasquatch package, now the Sasquatch package is the off-road package, bigger tires, a little bit more off-road goodies. Now, the four-door, and the four-door, you know, more practical and stuff like that, and the four-door Sasquatch package. Now, yes, the Sasquatch package really enhances your capabilities when it comes to your off-road capableness. But the cool thing is, the two-door is better on paper, and it's a little bit more small, so nimble on trails and stuff like that. But if you have a family and you want to take them off-roading, that Sasquatch package is the right one for you. Now, power plants. You can get, well, two to choose from as of right now. A four-cylinder, 2.3-liter EcoBoost engine, making 300 horsepower and about 325 pound-feet of torque. Very healthy numbers. Now, if you want more power, you can move on up to the 2.7-liter V6 EcoBoost engine. Now, that engine, a little bit more power, about 330 horsepower and 415 pound-feet of torque. Now, both these engines, you can either get a 10-speed automatic on both, but only if you want a manual transmission, you have to get the four-cylinder. But that manual transmission is a 7-speed, and it has a granny gear. Old-school granny gear guy. So basically, when you put in that granny gear, it's a super low range, nice for crawling up stuff and stuff like that. So it's really cool to see it here on a modern vehicle. Now, briefly talking about the interior. The interior is all squared off, but it's still full of tech. You have lots of good goodies when it comes to your lockers, nice little buttons on top of the dash. And obviously, as you go through the packages and get a little bit more expensive, you have more buttons, more off-road goodies. Goat modes, depending on which trim you have, you'll have more and more goat modes. Goes on all-terrain. Basically, they're saying that this is an all-terrain vehicle, just like the Jeep Wrangler is. But the cool thing is, you can go from an 8-inch touchscreen in the middle all the way up to a 12-inch screen. You have regular gauge cluster in front of the driver, or it can go up to a 6.5-inch digital helper with a little bit of analog gauges to the sides. You can get nice textiles in the interior with different textures and stuff like that to really spruce some things up, or you can get a little bit more luxurious and get leather seats and stuff like that. So you have options. Now, the base Bronco is just called the base. Now, it's just under $30,000. The price I have is with the destination fees and stuff like that. And then a four-door one is a little bit more pricey. It's just under $35,000 for a base. But this thing can go all the way up into the 50s, depending on how much you want to spend. The Wildtrak is currently at the top of the king. Yes, there is a first edition one, but it's the first edition is already called for and stuff like that. But the Bronco is finally here, and people are loving it. And that's the big thing about it, guys. This vehicle has just so many good off-road goodies. It's finally bringing competition to the Jeep Wrangler. It's bringing back an iconic name, the Bronco. And it's doing it with a family, guys. They have the little Bronco Sport if you don't really have the money for it and you just want something that's a little off-road capable, going to this big Bronco in the traditional two-door, my favorite personally, and a more practical four-door variant. But I want to know what you guys think. What are things you like and don't like about the new Bronco? Do you like the two-door more, or do you like the four-door more? And if you picked one, would you go for the hard top, which is a multi-piece system, or would you choose a soft top, which is right for you? And is the Bronco enough to sway you over if you are looking for a Jeep Wrangler, or is the Jeep Wrangler still the way to go? Please let me know in the comments down below. And guys, if you haven't already and you want to, please check out my channel. I keep trying to give you guys more and more content. It's about cars, trucks, crossovers, and SUVs, combustion engines, just like this, and EVs, a little of everything. But please, like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell. That way you guys can stay up to date with the latest and greatest for my channel. And as always, I truly, truly appreciate you guys for watching. And I'll see y'all in the next one.